Hey guys, your new intern is here!
Intern?
Yeah, his name is Eidex.
We were never told about getting an intern.
Yeah, well, our boss kinda sucks.
Well, catch you guys later.
Hey guys, what's going on?
You two idiots! Come to my office now!
Kid, I'm sorry what you're gonna be forced to go through.
You three! This includes you, unpaid intern!
I have a name. It's Eidex.
Don't care! Anyway, you guys are switching to a new programming language. This! Now go outside! Your boat is here now!
Boat?
Yes, boat! Now scram! Now! Go!
This is stupid. This is really, really stupid.
I should have gone for a different internship. Yeah, you should have.
Argh is an esoteric programming language that was created by Sasha Vilde in 2004. I hope I didn't butcher your name. It is two-dimensional, which means that instead of being run line by line like a typical programming language, it runs on a grid of one-character symbols. A command pointer starts in the top left of this grid and traverses it, running commands represented by certain symbols until it reaches the exit. To move the pointer around the Argh map, you use the letters L, J, H, and K. And none of those letters make any sense. I mean, you would assume L to go, I don't know, left? Well, you know what they say about assuming. It's bad and you should not have assumed I was gonna make the ass out of you and me joke. Anyway, the letter L makes the pointer go right. For some reason. The Argh program on the screen right now makes the command pointer run in circles. The letter L moves it to the right, the letter J moves it down, the letter H moves it to the left, and the letter K moves it up.
Argh was originally published on a German website. Maybe the letters would make sense in German.
Well, Recht and Links don't really match up with the Argh commands either. Wait a minute. A main feature of Argh is its simple error messages. When you make a mistake, such as having the pointer enter a square that does not contain a valid command, instead of Argh giving you a detailed explanation of your mistake, it simply outputs Argh! Matey. Argh programs are limited to 80 columns and 40 rows. An extended version that hopes to be Turing complete gets rid of the rows restriction and lets you use an infinite number of rows. That version is called Argh! Yee. A hopefully simple type of program is one that prints words to a screen. Argh makes doing this rather easy. The letter P will print a character to the screen. If it is a lowercase p, it will print the character in the cell below the p. If it is an uppercase p, it will print the character in the cell above the p. This program here prints hello world to the screen. At the end, the pointer lands on the Q instruction, which stops the program from running. If you don't have that Q there, Argh. So you want to see how disgusting Argh programs get? Well, a popular Esolanging problem that exists is the truth machine. Basically, you put in either a 0 or a 1. If it's a 0, it prints a 0, and that's it. If it's a 1, it prints a 1, and another 1, and another 1, and it keeps doing that forever. That sounds like it shouldn't be too bad, but the Argh truth machine looks like this.
Are you sure that's code? I mean, it looks just like random letters!
Well, welcome to Esolang. The command pointer starts by moving to the right, and it gets a character as input from the user with the G command. The lowercase g means that it will place the input on the cell below the G. Almost all Argh commands have two variants, uppercase and lowercase. Uppercase deals with the cell above the command, and lowercase deals with the cell below the command.
So wait, the symbol is placed there. Like, in the code. I could run that if I wanted to.
Yes! But we won't be doing that here because neither 1 nor 0 is an actual Argh command. It would probably print Argh if we went there. After getting input, the pointer hooks around until it reaches the S. The uppercase S will take the value above it and put it onto the data stack. This is an Esolang based around single characters, of course it has a stack. A stack is a data structure that can basically be visualized as a tower of numbers. You can push something to it, which adds it to the top, and you can also pop something from it, which removes it from the top. Kinda like the clues in Jeopardy, you remove them from the top. Oh wait, my analogy is a failure. Oh wait, due to my horrendously slow production speed, Jeopardy is a stack again! The stack in Argh is used for long-term data storage, while actual program space is pretty much limited to short-term data storage. That is because a cell only has two places where it can be accessed. Now that our input is stored on the stack, the value of the character 0 is subtracted from it. This is done using the R command, which will reduce the top value on the stack by the symbol either above the R or below the R, depending, of course, on the casing of the R. In this case, the R is lowercase, so we subtract the value below the R.
Wait, why are we subtracting 0 from 0? Isn't 0 just 0?
No, this 0 is not actually 0. What we have in the stack is the ASCII code for 0, which is just a 48 pretending to be a 0. Basically, every character you can type on the keyboard has a character code represented by a number, and the one for the 0 character is 48. Subtracting 0 from 0 here is actually subtracting 48 from 48, and gives us the actual, real, true 0, not this IMPOSTER! For the record, 1's ASCII code is 49, so doing this subtraction with a 1 would yield the real, true 1. Now it's time for the output. The command pointer will reach an X, which is a fork in the path. The pointer then looks at the top value on the stack. If that value is positive, the pointer will turn right from the direction it is already going. So if it was going to the right at the start, it would switch to going south. If the top value is not positive, it will keep going forward. 0 is not positive, nor is it negative, it's just 0. That means that, if you have a 0 on the stack and you reach the X, it will keep going straight. In this program, it prints a 0 and the program ends. If you typed a 1, the pointer will start moving downwards. Here, it will run in circles, printing out 1s. What a fantastic life that must be, just running in circles, printing out 1s for all eternity. And that is the Argh Truth Machine.
So, how are you doing, Carl?
Bleep! Seasick!
So, is there a parrot or something on board? I mean, this is a pirate ship, after all.
No, we have a cat computer, though, for some reason.
How are you, cat computer?
How are you, cat computer?
Why did you repeat me?
Why did you repeat me?
I hate myself because I'm a dumb, stupid computer!
I hate myself because I'm a dumb, stupid computer.
Ha! I got you!
Ha ha ha, I got you.
A cat program is a simple program where you type something and it spits it back at you. The Argh cat program looks like this. Press F to pay respects to the sanity lost while trying to program in Argh. Like the truth machine, the cat program begins with taking input from the user and putting it onto the stack. After that, however, things quickly become different. It duplicates the top value of the stack, allowing us to use it twice. It then immediately uses up one of those values on the stack and puts it back onto the program field. This is accomplished using the F opcode. Next, it prints the character that the F command just placed. No big deal. Now comes the part where the program decides if it wants to keep going or to end. The A command is like the reduce command, but instead of reducing from the top value on the stack, it adds. Specifically, in this context, it adds the value of a blank square to the value currently on the stack. Immediately afterwards, it subtracts the value of an exclamation point. After doing that, the stack will contain a value that is positive if, and only if, there is another character on the stack to be printed. If there is one, the program loops again, this time with the next character. If there isn't one, the program simply ends. And that is the cat program! Okay, I know it's not perfect. I mean, yes, it's got that there, but I'm too lazy to fix it and I think it works fine.
Well, I have this message that I want Creaturey to read, but not my annoying boss. And for some reason, I must use an Argh program to send it. What do I do?
Well, use this cipher program. It's like the cat program, but right before printing a character, it adds G and subtracts A. This should put it 6 ASCII values ahead of where it started. So, J would become P.
So, how do I decode it?
Using the D-cipher program! It's the exact same as the cipher program, just with the A and the G flipped. Doing this will change it from moving 6 ASCII values forward to 6 ASCII values backward, restoring the original message. And yes, these cipher programs still have residual characters that I do not care about.
Hey, I'm not stupid! Do you think this is funny?
A little.
This is your boss! Come back now! Right here! This experiment has been a failure! Boats are dumb! You've gotta be kidding me! He put us on a boat for nothing!
I'm sorry, kid. This is gonna be a rough summer for you. So, you might be saying, Argh is a Befunge clone! So, here are some differences between Befunge and Argh. Mainly so I can justify spending so much time making a video about Argh. In Befunge, the pointer can go onto blank tiles. In Argh. In Befunge, the symbols actually represent what they're doing. Like, you can probably tell that these arrow symbols actually move the pointer around. In Argh, the letters sometimes make sense, but sometimes they don't. Befunge actually allows you to choose where to put symbols when you're adding them directly into the source file. In Argh, you can choose between a staggering two locations, above or below. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time!